Welcome to St. James's Church for our Christingle service in these very strange COVID times. My name is Ellen Leeke and I'm a licensed lay minister at St. James's Church in Streatham. Thank you very much for joining us here for this special family service today. We have pre-recorded this from our home to yours as we are all watching this on YouTube from our various homes. So let us all responsively read our introduction sentences, with you reading the words in yellow. Christ has brought us out of darkness to live in his marvelous light. Jesus Christ is the light of the world. Jesus is our way. With Jesus, even dark places are light. Jesus is the truth. In Jesus, we shall live forever. Jesus is our life. And now we'll have our first song. Please do sing along with us. Sing Christingle.
Christingle begins with an orange, telling us of the world God made. By the fruits of the earth in the seasons, we can see the love of God displayed. Sing Christingle, sing Christingle, sing Christingle, it's the light of Christ. Sing Christingle, sing Christingle,
Bible reading is from John chapter 1 verses 1 to 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and through the world was made through him. The world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human dissension, or a husband's will, but born of God. The word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Let's have a little chat about this Bible reading that Sheena just read for us. So in the first sentence here, it says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And in the Bible, the word is with a capital W. So what do you think that means? What is the Word? The Word was with God. The Word was God. What is John writing about? Do you know?
I don't know.
It's kind of confusing. So actually, John, who was one of Jesus' disciples, is talking about Jesus here. So he's calling Jesus the Word. Jesus was with God, and the Word was God. So Jesus is with God. Jesus is God. And let's look at the first part of this sentence. In the beginning was the Word. So Jesus is there right from the beginning of Genesis, right from the beginning of the world. So Jesus does come down. We believe in God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, a triune God, three who's and one what? One God, three who's. So this is the Word, and it's talking about Jesus. So Jesus is at the beginning, at the creation of the world, in the beginning of Genesis, and he's with God, and he is God. So Jesus comes down from heaven to earth and is born as a baby. Let's see what else we have here. Through him all things were made. So how did, in Genesis, do you remember how God created the world?
Not exactly.
Okay, so we look back in Genesis and it said God spoke. So God created the world through speech, through his speaking. And who is that? That's Jesus is the Word. So God created the world with Jesus. It says right here, John was writing, through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has made, been made. Wow, so Jesus is God. Jesus is at the beginning. Jesus comes to earth years later as a baby. Verse 4, in him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. So Jesus is the life of the world, the life of mankind. And it says in verse 5, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Jesus is the light of the world. Jesus overcame darkness. We go 33 years after he was born and he was crucified on a cross. He did die, but he was resurrected. He overcame death. And why did he do that? Do you know why Jesus went to the cross and died? Did he die for any reason, you think?
No.
That's kind of a strange question. Jesus died for you. He died for me. He died for every one of us, so that we could have a relationship with God. So we could be in union with God. He died. He took on all of our sins, all of my bad things, all of your bad things, all of everybody's bad things. And he took them on himself so that we could be stand before God, washed clean, because Jesus has taken away all of our sins. But only if we come to Jesus, say truly sorry, and try to change our ways. So, it talks at the end about glory, doesn't it? The Word became flesh. Here in verse 14, this is Jesus becoming a little baby. The Word, so Jesus, became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory. John did see his glory. John was one of his disciples. The glory of the one and only Son who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. So Jesus gives us grace, doesn't he? He forgives us. When we come to him and say we're very sorry, he forgives us because he loves us so much that he died on the cross for us. And anyone who believes him and puts their faith and trust in him will be able to live forever with God. That's a Christmas present, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So, let's start by making a Christingle, okay? We're going to go get our things to make our Christingle. Why don't you gather yours now, too? So we have gathered our things that we needed to make our Christingles. We each have an orange, and we each have a little bit of tinfoil here, and a candle. Now I have a birthday candle, and Sheena's got the traditional Christingle candle, but any kind of candle you can find is fine. And we have four cocktail sticks with some sweeties on them that look like this. Now, we don't have that many sweeties in our house, so we have some marshmallows and some sultanas. But any kind of sweeties that you can put on four cocktail sticks is perfect. And then we're supposed to have a red ribbon. Now, Sheena's got a red ribbon because they made Christingles at school. So that's from her Christingle that she made from school. And this is some red yarn. And this is what we have in the house. So if you don't have a ribbon or yarn, then just some red paper or some white paper that you color in red and cut out in a strip. That would be fine too. So first things, we start off with an orange. And what does the orange represent, Sheena?
The world, doesn't it?
It represents the world. That's right, because Jesus came for the world, for everybody. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to put our red ribbon around it. And what does the red ribbon signify? Do you know, Sheena?
Jesus's love and blood.
That's right. Jesus died for every one of us, but he loves us so much. So what I've got is a little bit of sellotape here for my yarn here, so it'll stay on. And Sheena's got a little bit of sellotape on hers too.
No, I don't. I lost it.
Oh, you lost it. Oh, do you need to get some sellotape then?
Yeah.
All right. We'll send Daddy to the kitchen. So now what do we need? Let's look at these cocktail sticks we have here. And what do they represent, do you think? Why do we have four of them?
I don't know why we have four, but don't they represent like God's creation or something?
Yeah, so we have four. We put them on the four, kind of on the top part of our Christingle here, and we put them to signify the four seasons, and all of the sweeties are all the blessings that God gives us throughout the year. So we've got the world, Jesus who surrounds the world, who loves us and died for every single one of us so that we could have a relationship with God. And we have some tape for Sheena here. And then we have these sweeties that signify the blessings, the seasons, all four corners of the world, and the blessings. Now, one last thing here. We have some tin foil and a candle. So you need to wrap the bottom of your candle and stick it in the top. Now, Sheena's with a birthday candle, you don't actually have to make a huge mark in the orange. It goes in pretty easily. But Sheena's orange, because it's a bigger candle, I used a knife to cut a big hole and have your mom or dad or a carer help you with that. And then we can kind of shove it down in there. That's right. So here we are. Hey, very good Christingle. And if you could take a picture of your Christingle at home and share it with us on social media, or you can email it to us and we can put it on our St. James's website and St. James's Facebook page. So now before we light our Christingles, Everybody, let's hold our Christingles, and Sheena's going to say a prayer. Together we say it.
Lord Jesus,
I stretch out my hands and receive this gift, and I hold it tight because it is mine, my Christingle. Light, fruit, sweets, color, but so much more precious than this. I hold in my hands a picture of your love. I imagine all the other special things I might hold. Lord Jesus, help me to remember those with little or nothing to hold, especially other children who don't have enough to eat or a safe place to live. Today, as I hold my Christingle and remember you, I pray that you would make me someone like you who will reach out my opened hands to give and love like you do. Amen. As you receive this light, remember that Christ is the light of the world. Whoever follows him will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Together we say, may these Christingles remind us to shine as lights in the world, bringing light and hope to those who walk in darkness. Starting this Christmas, let's decide to be people who pass on the light of Jesus to others, to the people in our street, the people at our school or workplace, our friends, our neighbors, those who are struggling with darkness in different ways and who need the light of Jesus. Because God's light is for sharing. So let's light our Christingles. Now, I didn't get a match or something to light mine, so we'll have to get Sheena's dad to go get us a match, but you'll need adult supervision for this, and make sure that you always keep your lighted Christingle upright. Okay, so we can light one. We'll light Sheena's first. You want to light yours. Well, then I'll have to hold the Christingle. Okay, so she wants to light the Christingle. We'll turn off our lights. Okay. So now she can hold her Christingle, and you take the unlighted one and you bend it, not the other way around. And then you turn it upright so the wax goes down. But the lighted candles are always upright. So now that we have our Christingles all lit, we'll sing together our last song, Silent Night.
Oh,
we say the blessing, do blow out your candles and put your Christingles down, as we're going to need to use hand and arm actions for our blessing. So the first thing we're going to do is put out our hands like this, like we're receiving a present. Then we're going to give ourselves a hug. Then we're going to hold hands with the person next to us. And then we're going to raise our hands up high. So let's start. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forever. Amen. So thank you for joining us. I hope you've had a wonderful St. James virtual Christingle. Please do take pictures of your Christingles and email them to me. And let me know if we can post them on our Facebook and our website. If you would like to donate a coloring of a Christingle, so perhaps you didn't have the orange and all the things, but you were able to do a coloring of a Christingle during this. If you'd like to post it in your window and take a picture of it, let other peoples around the village see it as they walk around the village looking at people's Christmas lights and things like that. Or if you'd like to donate it to St. James, please do let me know. And we'll laminate it and put it on our gates of the church so others can see it there. So don't forget to put your Christingle in your windows, lighted every night for just a little bit, so you can remind yourself and others that Jesus is the light of our world. Here at St. James, we pray that you have a blessed Christmas and connect with us through other Christmas services. Take care. Bye-bye.